Hey, y'all.
So, some of my arrows got messed up at Orc Wars, which videos will be coming soon. And I had some questions about arrows. So I figured as I did some repairs, we would talk about them. Either the checker had much rougher hands than I do. Oh, there we go. Okay. So, LARP arrows. So, let's go ahead and... get this baby unwrapped. And this is why we have editing. There we go. Alright. Okay. An arrow. It's just a simple arrow shaft that you can get from any sports store. Yes, the tip has been removed. We do not fire arrow shafts that still have tips on them. Yes, people have tried to do that. And that's one big reason why the safety standards on arrows are so absolutely rigid. Anyway, but that's all. It's just basic arrow shaft you can get from any sporting goods store. Now the heads, there's a little bit more to them than that. Now, these are about $8 a piece. So I will not be cutting it apart to show you what the inside looks like. Sorry, guys. Okay. But just to give you a quick breakdown, you of course have the PVC core, which the arrow shaft will be inserted into. And from there, you have essentially three layers. You have the soft squishy layer, or what will eventually be the soft squishy layer. You have a polymer foam, polyurethane foam base. This is usually about two layers thick. Generally, that's made out of, it's like the same blue foam that you see in like camping mats. Some will also use the gray foam that you find in like those puzzle mat pieces, but you'll generally have two layers of that and then just another layer of some kind of foam to make the triangle that leads you on the base. Now, usually the last thing is that you wouldn't be able to see it here, but if you could look down that and see what's in there, there is a penny that is attached to the base of the connector. What that is to prevent, should enough force be inflicted, that this will not go through the foam and completely out the arrowhead. So they're, most people just use pennies, but you can use some kind of penny equivalent to put that stopper at the end of the base. Okay. Now for clarification, I am only going by the rules that I am familiar with. The only LARP games that I have personally played are Dagger Here, Amp Guard, Belagarth, which is kind of the same thing, and a game called Darkon. But so I am using the rules that I know for those games. Now each game, their arrow rules are going to be a little different, so make sure that depending on what game you're playing, go to the website and check out what their specifics are. Now you can go online and you can put in LARP arrows and you can buy some, but the ones you buy may not meet the qualifications of whatever game you are trying to play. So again, make sure you check the specific rules and make sure that whatever arrows you're getting meet the requirement for that, for the game you're doing. A lot of times, if the company that's making them is from retired LARPers, is they will usually state in their product description which games those particular arrows do qualify to play, or can pass the safety requirements to play. So to attach the shaft, not an overly difficult thing. You just take the tip, Take some duct tape. Now the hard part is being able to put on just enough duct tape that you can get it inside the base and it not move. But it also not fail to go in. So I just added a single layer and I'm going to try to shove it into this hole. And it will not go. So I'm going to take off the smallest amount of duct tape. Now, one thing you don't want to do, and I have done this, is you push out so hard trying to get in the thing that you actually completely detach the base from the head. And you basically just destroy the thing. And there we go. Now we have a head that does not move. And then from here, I'm going to take some more athletic tape, which I left in the work bag, and we'll continue to wrap it. Now I'm actually going to end up having to take this apart because yes, the fletchings do have to still be there, and on this arrow they're not. But I figured that gives you a basic idea what a LARP arrow essentially comprises of. If you got any questions, feel free to put them in the comments. Anyway, so that was it. I got like 4 more of these things to fix, so see y'all next one.